Adults who are bullied in the workplace is an issue that's starting to get national attention.
Yeah, a recent study survey finds more than one in three U.S. workers report being bullied. KCRA3's Tom Duhane live in the newsroom with what can be done to prevent workplace bullying. Tom.
Well, one expert who's speaking in Sacramento tonight says this problem must be recognized and then called out. He says that workplace bullying is kind of like domestic violence was 25 years ago. Everybody knew about it, but it was not discussed.
A 2010 Zogby poll finds 35% of U.S. workers say they've been bullied. Another 15% say they've witnessed workplace bullying. What exactly is it? Experts say repeated health-harming abusive conduct committed by bosses 72% of the time or coworkers 28%.
The best way to characterize workplace bullying is domestic violence at work.
Dr. Gary Namie is an expert, co-author of this book and founder of a bullying institute.
Threats, intimidation, humiliation, sabotage, or exploitation of a vulnerability. You find somebody's weak spot and you go after them.
So it's not just a tough or demanding boss. It's someone who specifically targets you with threats and humiliation.
We asked people in Sacramento what they have experienced.
I've seen someone being bullied at work. I never was bullied.
There was a guy that was picked on. And they wouldn't be able to work there for very long because they never felt very comfortable.
This man said he was ridiculed and called names by his boss after a construction accident. And this retired teacher.
I think I've experienced it to a small degree.
And Namie says one field with a lot of bullying is healthcare.
Just ask any nurse. They call it lateral violence. They know the creed is nurses eat their young.
He says stopping a bully isn't easy. The employer must take action.
What you have to do is go as high up as you can to convince the owner or a senior executive that the bully's too expensive to keep.
Dr. Namie, by the way, is holding a seminar on this topic tonight at the Radisson Hotel in Sacramento. He says lawsuits are not going to solve this problem. He's advocating changes in employment law that would force employers to resolve what he calls toxic workplaces. In the HD Newsroom, Tom Duhane, KCRA 3 reports.